looked at Turkey and a couple of numbers that came out. State Bank of Mysore reported what was a positive set of numbers. In fact, they had a good amount of asset quality improvements, and the stock was quite active on the upside in yesterday's trading session, but was a little downbeaten today. To talk more about the numbers, we have Mr. Sharad Sharma, the Managing Director of the company, joining in to talk to us. Hi, Mr. Sharma. Thank you very much for joining in, and congratulations on what's been a good improvement in your asset quality. Can you tell us what led to the improvement in the gross NPL?
Normally, if you on a year-to-year basis, last 13, we had asset quality, our NPL level was at 2,800. And we come down to 2,100, that's a reduction of 700 plus. Aggressively through recovery of written off assets and upgradation of assets also. Some asset sales were there to build up. So, my slippage overall being zero was 1,800 plus.
Quarter four
slippage was not too much actually. And we saw more on the positive side because there was some restructuring we were done. There was a deadline also of 31st March.
Okay.
So some land value of house on a construction basis that had happened. But a lot of obligations happened in the last quarter also, simultaneously. So we are in which we recovery in the first.
Good morning, sir.
Morning.
This is the worst of asset quality pressure behind, and going forward, what kind of asset quality can we see in the next financial year?
To take it back a little bit, actually, State Bank of Mysore had one of the top 5 in terms of gross NPA in December 13. And if you look at it in the last 5 quarters, maybe every quarter we will be reducing it by 40%, 33 basis points or so. So, yes, we were a little aggressive in terms of identification and in terms of write-offs also. And now we are seeing the recovery part of it. So that when you look at it, we well provided our NPOs, our GNP, our PCR is at 69, about 69%. So hopefully that, the slippage, the pace of slippage during the previous year and the fourth quarter has come down substantially.
Okay. I just wanted a couple of figures from you, sir. How much did you sell in terms of your loans to asset reconstruction companies this quarter? And how much do you traditionally do?
To give an example, in the last year, for the full year, we had done about 800 crore sales to ARC. For this, in the last quarter, it was only 60 crores. And in the first quarter of the year, we had 2-3 accounts with the sale of the ARC. After that, after the RBI guidelines came from 5% to 15%. So the capacity and the business which was done through the ARC, that came down.
Okay.
Overall for the industry also.
Okay, so that means that obviously you had, an organic, to say, improvement in your asset quality this quarter. So what were your recoveries, upgrades and your fresh slippages? I have to figure for last quarter, which was 421 crores. Which were your fresh slippages? Is it higher, lower, same?
And the net reduction in NPA is 700 crores. So 2,500 crores was the aggregate recovery, the improvements which has happened in the NPA book.
Sorry. Mr. Sharma, your margins came down this quarter a bit, not by much, but what's the outlook on that in the next
Over the last 2 years, if you look at it, every quarter is a very tight banding if you're operating. The 5 basis points between 3.03 to 2.98. So this quarter was 2.98, but we are also doing certain that around the 3% level is what we are looking at.
So, we've spoken extensively about asset quality, but we've seen a couple of NBFCs such as Eminent Finance as well as L&T Finance Holding which have reported improvement in gross NPLs. Don't you like to niche in their own sectors and their focus? Do you see the industry as a whole maybe seeing a bit of a recovery as maybe the gross NPLs have now bottomed out and you could see a little bit of sustainability improvement?
If you look at the corporate segment basis, that recovery on the banking side we are yet to see. So on a net basis, the corporate banking book has not grown during the year. But what we have done is shifting from 65% corporate exposure, we have reduced the balance sheet exposure of corporate assets to 35%.
Okay.
And we have gone on to the retail side. The retail side, we are located in Bangalore. a fairly healthy city in terms of housing and so our personal loan book aggregate on an average basis went up by 17% and our housing portfolio went up by 22%.
Okay.
So, and we intend to grow on that further.
Okay.
So the expansion of our retail book being currently will also be more than the corporate book.
And what was credit growth for this quarter and what you envisage maybe in FY16?
The average credit growth for the bank was 8.9%.
And for FY16, when did you see a pickup?
Corporate side, we don't see any pickup in the first half at least. Second half is more nifty. So, I'm looking at the major growth only on the retail side, per se, as of now.
Okay, so Mr. Sharma, now that the merger of subsidiaries with the State Bank is put on hold for at least the foreseeable future, what is the outlook going forward for your standalone entity?
See, I think the State Bank of Mysore is actually located in Karnataka. We are a niche market over there. After actually Bombay, Bangalore has the largest concentration of public sector banks. But if you look on the retail side of our CASA, if you look at our CASA, CASA is about 33% this year, highest level of the public sector banks. So that is what gives us confidence. Our bulk deposits for the other banks is very low, it's about 6-7%. So our cost of funds are fairly okay. So aggressively going on the retail side, and the housing and the other loans. So, and Bangalore, if you look at it, I mean, almost, I think Mysore had done an analysis of 130 countries, cities in the world, and Bangalore is the only, is the top Indian city with the color of 127 lakhs.
Okay.
And the water middle class is there. So, in terms of NPM also, it's a little better. So, that gives us confidence that we go on that, and that's the niche thing.
Okay, just one last question from my side and Mr. Sharma. It's a two-part question. One, how did you read the PSL norms that came out last evening? And secondly, in terms of your gross NPLs, will you see a further improvement in maybe this quarter?
Okay, taking your second question first, yes. We will definitely see an improvement. Anything is significant, even at 4%. NPL levels are because there was not much of credit growth. So the denominator did not grow, which we think will happen now. And there are some recoveries which we have already lined up. So we still improve the asset quality further. Largely not to this extent, but there will be an improvement which will happen. And the other question regarding the private sector norms, we are fairly well served if every private sector percentage is 18.5%. The only shift is done is that we have taken the direct and indirect thing away. So, 8% in small and marginal farmers, that could be a little bit of a issue. But other than that, saying not on a year in basis, but on a quarterly basis, that is fine. And what I would look at as a positive side is an affordable housing. Mm. 35 lakhs project cost and 28 lakhs of main bill cover in the private sector. So that's a huge benefit for us as we look at it.
Okay. All right, Mr. Sharma, thank you very much for joining in and talking to us. So that's the management of State Bank of Mysore detailing their quarterly figures to us.